All right, my buddy Lee Spiegelman is back with us. We always get great buzz on every time Lee is on because he takes unconventional positions.
Our nearly $800 billion goods trade deficit is costing us 3.5 to 4 million jobs a year, and being our workers being undercut from foreign imports and from offshoring of plants owned by Americans has caused a downward wage vortex in this country. That's why middle class incomes have not improved. They've stagnated or actually gone down in real terms over the past 20 years. This importing and offshoring orgy that we've had over the past decades has imploded American middle class incomes. More companies can build here in the United States. They're already doing it, as you pointed out in the previous segment. They can do a lot more of it. There is no reason for large-scale manufacturing imports in this country, and we need a tariff to advance that process to make our economy stronger. That is a national security issue. That is the only way we're going to be able to afford funding our military and be able to stand up to foreign enemies.
I love you to death. I love you to death, and especially when you use words like orgy when we're talking about trade. But be careful what you wish for.
Our trade deficit with China is funding the Chinese military. It's funding the research that they're doing on AI, artificial intelligence, to overtake the United States. Mm-hmm. We are literally sowing the seeds of our own destruction. Neil, if we Americanize American manufacturing, if we re-domesticate our supply chain, it will create an explosion of investment. It will create an upsurge in American jobs and incomes. Middle-income Americans have had stagnant or declining real incomes over the past 20 years. The overwhelming reason for that is the deindustrialization of America caused by these horrific trade deals that have been made, which has also decimated the African-American middle class in northern industrial cities. That was the ladder to the middle class for African-Americans that fled the Jim Crow South after World War II.
All right.
And here, after one generation, because of this deindustrialization, we decimated our inner cities and decimated so many other millions of jobs around the country and imploded American incomes. When you have this leakage of incomes, when people can source goods in China for $5 an hour, workers making $5 an hour or less, that has a tremendously deleterious effect on American workers. Whenever you hear the phrase free trade, that is code for cheap foreign labor. And unfortunately, Wall Street fat cats are addicted to that. And too often, it appears the president is basing trade policy on Wall Street market reaction, which is kind of like a bar asking its patrons when happy hour should be over. that makes absolutely no sense. We've got to look long term in this country. And agricultural exports are great. Our farmers are crucial, mainly because they feed the American people. But we have to keep in mind that our deficit in cars with the rest of the world, just our car deficit, exceeds our total agricultural exports. So the future of this country has got to be based on advanced manufacturing, on artificial intelligence, not agricultural exports. We've got to get that back in line and have our priorities in place, because that's where the jobs of the future for the middle class of this country are coming from. And that's what's important, not what a bunch of Wall Street fat cats think is important, which is fatter corporate profit margins, tons of money pouring in from overseas and invested on Wall Street. That's not what the average American in this country needs. We have a $400 billion goods trade deficit with China. And even if this, as rumored, this agreement, this phase one, whatever that means, happens, and China were to start buying $40 billion a year of U.S. agricultural products, Neil, that would only shave 10%, $40 billion, off of our humongous $400 billion goods trade deficit with China.
You're in the mindset, look, it's not worth signing on, even though it's the first phase and there are other promises of phases to come. You just don't buy it. Don't sign on to this.
I don't buy it. Neil, China cheats. And as I've said before, Robert Lighthizer and his team are brilliant, but it doesn't matter how terrific the deal they negotiate is. And this is not a very terrific deal, frankly, from what I'm hearing. But even if it were, China cheats. They're not going to live up to it. They've never lived up to their trade agreements in the past. Why are they going to start now? The one thing we can do that we can measure and that we can enforce and that's worked in this country for 200 years is impose tariffs. And those tariffs provide desperately needed revenue for our country.
And we have got to do that. That needs to be the way that we do this policy, not some agreements that we can't police and we can't enforce. That would level the playing field. It would lead to a vast expansion of American manufacturing, growth in American middle class incomes, and increased jobs for the middle class. That's very important. And on top of that, as I mentioned earlier, it would raise an additional $300 billion a year. Neil, what President Trump has failed to do with his trade policy and the tariffs is lay out a plan. What could this country do with the $300 billion a year in revenue from a 15% import tariff? That would be enough to give us $150 billion to give a private health insurance policy to every uninsured American. That would be enough to give us $50 billion a year to make the middle income tax cuts permanent. Right now, the number one selling vehicle in the United States is our pickup trucks. The three top-selling brands of vehicles in the United States are pickup trucks. Neil, they have a 25% tariff. So in other words, they are almost all made in the United States because of a 25% tariff that Lyndon Johnson put on pickup trucks back before hardly anybody bought them in the 1960s. So if tariffs are so bad, why are they working so well for pickup trucks in this country? Why have they cut the ones that Trump put on? Why have they cut our Chinese trade deficit by 20% year to year?